Welcome to yet another interesting and exciting session of cookery and fun here at the Chakle Academy. Today, it's time for us to welcome a new batch of cooks who are here to study and learn a little bit about the nuances of Indian sweets and desserts. So, we are gonna have Sanchita, Natasha, and Rita. Let's have them in.
Hi, I'm Natasha Bhardwaj and I'm training to be a pilot. I have a little 4-year-old daughter who's extremely fond of sweets. So here I am at the Chakle Academy to take care of all the sweet cravings that my little angel has.
Hi, I'm Sanchita. I'm working for media marketing and sales and I'm a complete foodie. I believe that you can't just love food, you've got to know how to make it as well. So I'm glad after this academy, I get a chance to treat my family and friends with yummy desserts.
Hi, I'm Rita Arora. I'm a journalist. I'm a complete foodie person. I love chocolates, ice creams and fruits. For me, dessert is the most important and interesting part of the meal. And what can be better than learning it from Aditya Bal?
Welcome to the academy. And this is where we are going to be creating a bit of magic and hopefully some madness along with it, okay? On our journey into the realm of Indian sweet dishes.
Yes, and we're excited.
And we're excited. I'm glad you should be excited because it is equally exciting for me to have you all here. Before we get going, let me tell you guys that Indian sweets are basically very simple, okay? But they require a bit of care in their cooking, a bit of patience, and lots of love. So if you like, you all can wear your aprons, the Academy aprons. We shall now show them what they are going to be vying for from the very start. Let's show you and introduce you guys to your apron of the day. So people, this is the apron of the day, and to build up your suspense, I shall read it out to you. It says, there is nothing in this world that a dessert cannot fix.
That's wow. So true.
You agree?
Yeah. Yes, totally.
Yeah? Okay, fine. So cool. So next time my car is broken down, I'll just, you know, go and pick up a dessert.
Just fix your mood.
It fixes your mood. Okay, that's what, exactly. We're coming to that. Let me put this away under lock and key. It's, you know, precious. So I shall just, yeah, lock it away. Okay? Simple sweetness. Shrikhand. It requires close to no cooking whatsoever. Then we're going to do a dudi ka halwa. You know dudi?
Mm-hmm.
Loki? Okay. Did you know that Loki would make a killer halwa?
I've heard of it, but never really tried it.
Okay, perfect. So that's the reason you're here, to try out stuff you haven't tried before. Okay, so let's begin first with our Shrikhand. It's a Kesar Shrikhand, for which we have saffron, hunkered, all right, which is basically curd with all of its whey or most of the whey extracted. And then we have some caster sugar. Then pista, almonds, milk. Okay, so we shall start by infusing this milk, okay, with this most expensive spice in the world, saffron. Let's begin our first infusion that we are going to do here. Into this pan, we shall add some milk, okay, and heat it up slightly, all right? For us to be able to infuse it with saffron or any other flavoring. Now, we can add a few of these strands of saffron, okay, and a few more. And that's it. That's already overshot our budget. I'm just joking. It's expensive. Use it sparingly. Okay, another thing. When you're using saffron, make sure you keep it covered in an airtight container such as this. And then this goes into the fridge. Okay, because exposed to sunlight, heat or air, saffron is so delicate that it loses a lot of its aroma and flavor. So turn this down. You can see it's come to a boil. And now you're going to see it start to color. So, our saffron has gone into the fridge. Now it is time for us to make the rest of the mix for our Shrikhand. Okay, now this is super simple, all right?